Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Ahkam SOS, the Ramadan edition. We would like to extend our congratulations, Ramadan Kareem, to you all and your families. And inshallah, this will be a month of taqwa and also of tawfiq, inshallah. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you improve your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that you have a month of blessing and a month of rejuvenizing your spiritual lifestyle, inshallah. Joining me on today's show, as always, is Sheikh Ali Ma'ar. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh, and Ramadan Kareem.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ramadan come to you as well.
And Sheikh, let's start with the word Ramadan. As in, where does it originate from, and what does it mean?
A'udhu billahi as-sami' al-alim min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين
اللهم صل
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. The word Ramadan in the Arabic dictionary, it means, when you take the word to its root, to the masdar, it will be Ramadan. Now the word Ramadan in the Arabic dictionary, it means the sunshine on the ground, on the stone and pebbles and such like, in the heat wave. So you have the heat wave of Arabia on the desert of the Arabia, on the stones and rocks and so forth. Now that's the to do with the dictionary's meaning. The meanings we have in various narrations, that Ramadan is the name of Allah, one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the narrations, they state that do not say Ramadan, say Shahr Ramadan.
Yes.
Because it's a sacred name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we've been encouraged to say the month of Ramadan, Shahru Ramadan, respecting this holy name, and also we respect the month itself, the month of worship, the month of ibadah and devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to continue by the meaning of Ramadan, the meaning of Ramadan, again, when we go back to the dictionary, it actually burns away the sins. So another meaning, that it burns away the sins. It's the month in which we prepare ourselves to get rid of all the bad habits, the bad sins, all the wrongdoings. And we try to take this opportunity in this holy month to purify ourselves and to cleanse ourselves from all the acts in which were some kind of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There were some kind of disagreement with the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's the best month for the one to purify himself and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rahmah and mercy and so forth.
MashaAllah, excellent. Sheikhna, is Ramadan and fasting actually mentioned in the Quran at all? And I mean, it's mandatory upon a Muslim to fast during Ramadan. But where is this mentioned in the Quran? Where is the hadith for it?
With regard to the fasting rule in the Holy Quran, the first ayah mentioned, which is a very famous and known ayah, usually it's been mentioned on TV, radio, and so forth. The ayah says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum al-siyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqoon. O you who believe, observing fasting is prescribed and became obligatory for you, as it was prescribed and obligatory for those who were before you, that you may become pious and God-fearing. Now the meaning of the ayah is that this holy month of Ramadan, the fasting of 29 or 30 days of 1 year, of that year, that actually is a wajib, obligatory upon every Muslim, male and female. They have to fast as they pray the daily prayers, as they go to the Hajj, and so forth. It's part of the furu' ad-din, as we have the 10 furu' ad-din, Salah, Sawm, Hajj, Zakat, Khums, and so forth. So that's part of it, part of the wajibat and obligatory acts. And it wasn't only wajib for us as Muslims. The Holy Quran says, كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, as it became obligatory upon those who were before you. There were religions, creeds before us. They also had to fast in their own way, own methods. So the previous religions, they also fasted their own months or days or whatever they had in their religion. So it is, let's say, some kind of Allah's sunnah or tradition that he would ask his worshippers to fast, not only in the Muslim Islamic religion, but also the previous religions also they had fasting. And I've seen some religions, they observe fasting, for example, Christians, others, they do have certain days, they don't eat meat, for example, and so forth. Something similar to fasting, although it's not like us, we refrain from eating and drinking and so forth. And the second ayah with this regard, the Holy Quran says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Inna al-Muslimina wal-Muslimat. And then the ayah reaches, Was-Sa'imina was-Sa'imat. So the ayah mentions the Muslims, male and female, and those who fast, male and female. Then Allah says at the end of the ayah, أَعَدَّ اللَّهَ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah provided them and offered them a great reward, a great position in the hereafter. So those who fast, they will gain a great reward in the hereafter. And the fasting is not just you benefit for the hereafter only. So it's just to get the higher positions of paradise. You know, you get the bounties of paradise, for example. There is a great portion of benefit in this world, a great benefit within our health system, body, you know, the body, the immunity system, for example, and so forth. We need fasting as part of our health, well-being and health. So it's not just for the reward of the hereafter.
Ahsant, Sheikhna. Sheikhna, what about the hadith that, you know, also complement this ayah or complement the, you know, fasting and to support fasting? Do we have any hadiths in regards to Ramadan and fasting?
There are numerous hadith with this regard, with regards to fasting. Also, there are quite few sermons of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. They speak about the month of Ramadan in the hadith and in their sermons. The first hadith or sermon, by the way, I would like to mention, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, on the last Friday of the month of Sha'ban, he went to the masjid and he gave a sermon, and he had this sermon about the forthcoming of month of Ramadan, welcoming the month of Ramadan within this sermon. The hadith is from Imam Ar-Ridha alayhi salam. He narrates that from his fathers and grandfathers alayhi salam, an Ali alayhi salam, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he made this sermon and said, أيها الناس إنه قد أقبل إليكم شهر الله بالبركة والرحمة والمغفرة. The Prophet said, O people, that the month of Ramadan had approached. The month of Allah had approached. This is the month of Allah, شهر الله. So the first thing, the first attribute of this month is that it is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanallah.
He attaches this month to Allah. So when we have such a great month that attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what are its features? The Prophet said, bil barakah, with the blessings, والرحمه with mercy, والمغفره with forgiveness. Three main features that we need in our life: mercy, blessing, and forgiveness. We need them always. So these are the main features of the month of Ramadan that you will get and gain as a person who observes fasting in this month. Then the Prophet says, شَهْرٌ هُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَفْضَلُ الشُّهُورِ. It is the best month amongst the other months of the year. وَأَيَّامُهُ أَفْضَلُ الْأَيَّامِ. And the days of the Ramadan are the best days compared to other days. وَلَيَالِيهِ أَفْضَلُ الْلَيَالِي. The best nights compared to other nights. وَسَاعَاتُهُ أَفْضَلُ السَّاعَاتِ. The best hours. Then the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وآله, يَنْظُرُ اللَّهِ فيها إلى عباده يجيبهم إذا ناجوا. He would, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would look at his servants, mm-hmm. and he would respond their calls. And to the end of the khutbah, ويستجيب لهم إذا دعوه. And he would answer their call, their haja, their need, if they call Allah and if they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a great benefits, bounties you would gain in the month of Ramadan. And the main benefit you get is the spiritual part of the month of Ramadan. That's what we need, really. Otherwise, you can observe some kind of other types of fasting, you know, those who go into diet and they try to do some kind of observing, some kind of reduced weight, like weight loss, for example. Mm-hmm. But the main feature of Ramadan is to do with the spiritual and the soul parts. That's very important, that we try to seek the perfection, spiritual perfection this month, and then we continue after this holy month for the rest of the year. You get the energy, you get the charge, yes. from this holy month for the whole coming year. Excellent. And also, there's a hadith with regard to the benefit, the bodily benefit. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Sumu tasahhu," fast, and you may become healthy. So that's the benefits of fasting.
There's biological, exactly. physical benefits of
exactly.
fasting.
Physical and bodily benefits from fasting. Also, in the narration of the khutbah and the sermon of Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha, when she gave this great sermon in the masjid of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, when her rights were usurped, she went and she mentioned the philosophy of the ahkam, the philosophy of why do we need to pray, why do we need to fast, why do we need hajj, why do we have to pay zakat, and so forth. And she mentioned siyam and fasting as well. She said, salamullahi alayha, faja'ala Allah, and then she said, as-siyama tathbeetan lil-ikhlas. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made fasting obligatory as a means of establishing sincerity. To establish sincerity, ikhlas, you get it when you are in a certain condition and position. So fasting is the best time and season for the one to gain sincerity and ikhlas and loyalty. So that's the best time for the one to take this opportunity and gain as much as we can from this holy month.
Ahsan, Shaykhna. Shaykhna, do we have anything that the Imams have told us directly in regards to fasting and so on?
Yes, of course. We have a hadith from Imam As-Sadiq alayhi salam where he says, إِذَا صُمْتَ فَلْيَصُمْ سَمْعَكَ وَبَصَرَكَ وَجِلْدَكَ. When you fast, make sure that your hearing, your sight, your hair, your skin, and other organs should also fast.
Oh.
So fasting is not just to refrain from eating and drinking. Mm-hmm. Everything in your body should also fast.
Okay.
From doing the haram, mm-hmm. from the haram looking. In the month of Ramadan, you have to observe these more than other months.
Okay.
To give you the opportunity and the training from stopping doing the haram.
Okay.
So if, God forbid, if somebody looks at the haram, watches indecent movies, for example, mm-hmm. If he touches the other for example, shake hands with the
opposite
other
gender.
With the opposite gender, for example, and if he speaks, you know, repulsive language and harsh words, swears and so forth, in this month is the best time to for the individual to have the training that he stops these things gradually, one by one. If I am used to lying, for example, I try to reduce it in this month, and it's the best time to for me to make the oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I won't lie anymore, for example. I won't be looking at the haram. I won't be watching those movies, those indecent movies,
so
for example.
Can we say it's the perfect time to actually purify your senses, whether it's hearing, sight, smell, taste, and also purifying the mind and also the heart from these haram acts?
Exactly. It's the best time. If I'm used to listening to music, for example, I stop it in the month of Ramadan, and I gradually to stop it forever, khalas, you know, to make the oath with Allah that I won't listen anymore. And it's the best time to protect myself from the waswasa of the shaitan. Because sometimes I do my best, I stop listening, watching, doing, you know, backbiting and so forth, but later on I go back and do the haram again. So it's the best time to do the oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and practically and pragmatically apply this and implement this on the real world, in my daily life, to stop it, khalas. I do the tawbah. That's why we have the tawbah, opens the doors of the tawbah, opens specifically in this month of Ramadan, that we ask repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the best time. Finally, I wish also to mention another hadith from Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Salamullah alayhi. He says, with regard to the philosophy of fasting, the reason and the cause of fasting, he says, إِنَّمَا فَرَضَ اللَّهُ الصِّيَامُ لِيَسْتَوَ بِهِ الْغَنِيُّ وَالْفَقِيرَ. Allah made fasting obligatory so that the rich and the poor, they may become equal. So you feel the hunger and the thirst of that poor person. And also the Imam Salamullah alayhi says, لِيَرَقَّ عَلَى الضَّعِيفِ وَيَرْحَمَ الْجَائِعِ. So when you have that feeling of hunger and thirst, so that rich person would donate. He said, I'm fasting 19, 20 hours a day in the heat wave, you know, in summertime, for example. Now I have to make sure that I also support those who are in need, those who have no bread to eat for their dinner, for example, nothing to eat. So I would, as a rich person, support and give donations. That encourages us to help the others, as the Imam Salamullah alayhi says. And inshallah, we try our best to practice the good deeds in this month as much as we can, to do the salihat as much as we can, and to refrain from muharramat. So two things, which is under the title of and subject of taqwa, doing good deeds and refraining the bad deeds. This is the best month and the best opportunity.
Ahsan, Sheikh, Ahsan. You know, we do take our lives for granted sometimes, and living here in the West, you know, we have much provided for us in terms of shelter, clothing, and also food. And I think Ramadan is a perfect time to actually try and understand and also sympathize with those who have less. And inshallah, it can inspire many people to, you know, go towards charity and also help those people in need, inshallah. Sheikhna, thank you very much. And that's all we have time for in today's episode. And I very much thank you to all of you joining us. And inshallah, may you have a blessed month of Ramadan, inshallah. And join us tomorrow and for the whole of Ramadan, where we will be focusing on ahkam in regards to fasting and the holy month of Ramadan, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.